put in place and publicly has said that 20 cases per 100,000 people, we're certainly well below that. And if anything, moving in the opposite direction way. I remind you, we are on 13 cases per 100,000 in the last 7 days.
Just to stop you there, I'm so sorry. What, on those seven islands, you are 20 cases per 100,000 or below?
In most of the islands, we have shared all the information. I can come back with the exact figures. I don't have the seven islands.
Right, but is it below 20? Is it below 20? That's the key thing.
In many of those islands, yes, of course.
Why do you think the UK government's made this decision then? Because that doesn't make sense, because 20 per 100,000 is the threshold for imposing quarantine.
Well, the rules for the UK government's decision are obviously their own, so I cannot go into those details.
What I'm saying is, and you're agreeing, is that some of the islands don't match the rules. So I'm asking you, what do you think is going on?
Well, as I said, I'm not going to comment on the decision. All I'm saying is that we are providing all the data that's required. We are still committed to ensuring that in all destinations we provide a safe experience as much as possible. Mm-hmm. We're taking often difficult decisions to impose restrictions where necessary, and we have done so with success, because many cases we brought the numbers down, and we are on average and the whole of the country bringing the cases down. So that's certainly, we feel we're doing everything we can to safeguard both our citizens and our visitors in terms of their health and safety.
Okay. Why won't you comment on the decision by the UK government?
Well, there is no reason to get into that. All I'm saying is that we have an open and transparent policy. We're sharing information with the UK government. And, of course, it's a sovereign right of every government to make those decisions.
Yeah.